beautiful human being. Here is Didi from Yoga Fitter and Stronger Forever. How are you today? How is the energy? Welcome back to my channel. This video is for people that have some problem to lose weight, okay? They're not really actually kind of chubby and round, but they tend to have some belly fat here. So if it's the case, please join me for this very gentle and relaxing session where we're gonna learn how to lose belly fat. Okay guys, so we're gonna start in seated position. So make sure that you're nice and comfy here. Okay, relax the thighs. And then just make sure that the flesh of your thighs are relaxing behind. Seated on the pubic bone and the sacrum, okay, so you have like a triangle shape between the two hip bones and the pubic bone and the sacrum. So that makes like a kind of little triangle. So make sure that you're really grounded and that you can stay in seated position for a very long time. This is what happens in meditation, okay? So we're not gonna do meditation. Just 5 simple exercises to reduce belly fat. So as you bring your hands onto your knees, close your eyes. We're gonna take a couple of breaths. Take a deep breath in. Inflate the belly. Relax the jaws, relax the shoulders. And then as you exhale, draw the belly back in. This is good, this is really good. Okay. And then again, inhaling. So let the air come into your nostrils. And then as you exhale, draw the belly back into the spine. And then last one, inhaling. So keeping the outer arches of the feet onto the ground, relax your knees, relax your face, smile. And then exhale. Draw the belly back into the spine. Release your exhalation onto the ground of your seat bones. And then very gently open your eyes. Okay, so far that was okay, right? Not too tough. Okay, so we're going to keep the hands onto the knees. Very gently as you breathe in, you're going to elongate the spine to the ceiling and you're going to bring the chest forward. And then as you exhale, bring the chin towards the chest, round the spine, look at your belly, okay? As you breathe in, chest forward, so you can push with your hands a little bit and gently come forward, option to look up to the sky. And then as you exhale, pivot, lean back, look at your belly, exhale. And then again, inhaling, forward, so really opening through the collarbone here. And then as you exhale, curl. So let the breath come back down to the seat bones like a dust after a thunderstorm, for example. And breathe out. And then again, inhale forward. So we're gonna go a little bit deeper now. Exhale back. Inhale forward, up and down. Exhale back. Last one, inhale forward. And then exhale back. Excellent. And then come back to the center. And then exhale. Okay. So we're gonna use a block. If you don't have a block, you can use a book, of course. But if you have a block, it would be more convenient. So come onto a seated position. Okay, onto your mat with the feet pressing down the ground. Keep elongate here, lengthening, lifting the spine, and then place the block between your knees. All right, and then very gently, so as you breathe in, you're gonna bring the hands behind your sit bones, okay? Maybe pressing through the fingertips. You don't have to bring the palm of the hands onto the ground, okay? Just the fingertips. Just relax the shoulders, and as you breathe in, you're gonna lift the legs up, okay? So fingertips are gonna come forward, not back. They're gonna face your big toes. But keep the grounding of your fingers. And then exhale here. So we're gonna straighten the legs. If your legs are not able to stretch parallel to the mat, you can keep them bent. And then we're gonna hold here for 10 breaths. So draw the belly in, inhale, and then exhale. Inhale, 2, exhale. Try to keep the spine elongated. Don't lean back like this, okay? Just keep the gait, belly engaged, 3, and 4, smile, and 5, keep the heels together, outer arches of the feet spread forward, inner arches of the feet connected. 4 more breaths here, 1, 2, keep the elbows bent, 3, and 4, and then gently release. Okay, just drop the block, and then we're going to come onto a lie down on the right hip joint, so starting from the right side, stretch your legs forward. So we're gonna pay attention to the forearm first, okay? So look at your forearm and then take a deep breath in. And then from there, we're gonna exhale and we're going to bend the knees and send the heels towards the sit bone. Lovely. As you exhale, pay attention to your left hand. Make sure that the left hand is really front of you, pressing to the ground. So far, so good. The feet are stacked on top of each other, knees stacked on top. And then as you breathe in, we're going to gently lift the top knee up and down. So we're gonna do that 10 times, okay? So once again, try to keep the belly engaged here. It's gonna engage by itself, but in case, okay? Try to really pay attention to the belly here, okay? Don't let it drop forward. Try to keep it engaged. And then we're gonna do 10 breaths here. Inhale, 1. Lift and up. Inhale, draw the belly in, lift and down. So it's important to draw the belly first in and then lift the knee and down. 3 and 4 and 5 and 6, 7, 8. You're doing great, guys. 9 and 10. And then gently release. Give yourself a little spank here. Lovely. And exhale. Okay. So we're gonna come onto hands and knees, all fours, to realign this all together. So make sure that the knees are aligned with the hips, okay? And then the shoulders are aligned with the wrist.
One of the reasons why I developed so much rest meditation.
Okay. Lovely. And then from there, so make sure that, so come on to cat-cow, all fours. Make sure that the wrists are aligned with the shoulders and then the knees are aligned with the hips. And then we'll do three cat. Inhale, chest forward. Exhale, curl. Inhale, forward. Exhale, round the spine. Drop the head down. So it doesn't matter how far you go, okay? Look at my spine, okay? It doesn't go very far. Exhale. And then inhale, forward, and round. Inhale, come back to cat-cow. And then we're going to come to lean onto the left side this time. So you can keep the blanket if you want, okay? If your hips are a little bit bony, okay? A little bit edgy. And then bring the legs stack on top of each other, feet stack, forearm parallel to the short side of the mat. We're going to bend the knees and then right hand come forward, inhale one, and down. So once again, think about belly in first and up. Two. Elongate the spine, so telescope the neck forward. Three. Four. And five. And six. Seven. Eight. Nine. And ten. Lovely, guys. Okay, drop the knee down. Excellent. Come back to all fours. We do another round here. So make sure that the wrist bones are aligned with the knees. And there we go. Inhale forward and go. Drop the head down, drop the chin down. Inhale forward and curl. Inhale forward and curl. Lovely. And then dropping the hip onto the ground again, coming back to seated position for the next one. So next one, you can use a blanket as well. So lean the sit bones onto the blanket, cross the legs. If you are more, let's say, comfortable with the legs and cross, but the soles of the feet together, you can, okay? Just make sure that you have enough space here into the groin, that you don't have any tightness in the groin. And then, as you breathe in, lift the arms up to the sky. Look at your hands. Maybe if your neck allows, otherwise just look down or look forward. And then exhale, release the hands back down. So very gentle, very basic exercise. But you see where we're going. Inhale, lift the arms overhead. So elongate the spine here and see the belly is lifting up towards the fingertips. And then exhale, bring the hands back towards the chest. So now watch, inhale, lift the arms overhead. But this time, we're going to interlace the hands together, flip the palms up to the sky, and then we're gonna gently tilt to the left. Okay? Exhale back to the center and release. Now, inhale, lift the arms overhead, interlace your hands, flip the palm up to the sky, exhale. And then as you push the palms up to the sky, inhale, we're going to pivot to the right. Very slowly, very gently. Don't go too far. If you feel like it's trapped in the upper back, okay, don't go too far. Exhale back to the center. Release. Lovely. Okay, maybe give yourself a little tilt of the neck here to make sure the neck is nice and soft. Exhale, tilt to the left, back to the center, tilt to the right, back to the center. So the next one is directly targeting the abdomen, okay? So as you breathe in, hands by the side of the hips, lift the arms overhead, and then as you exhale, this time, tilt again to the left, but this time bring your right hand to the left knee and now your left hand behind you. And twist. Exhale. Inhale, come back to the center. Lift the arms overhead. Left hand comes to the right knee. And then extend the right arm behind. You see where we're going? Exhale. Again, inhale, back to the center. Lift the arms overhead. Look at your fingers. Deep breath in. And then exhale. Twist to the left. Lovely. Come back to the center. Inhale, arms up. And twist to the right. Breathe out. Lovely. And then back to the center. Last one, last round. Inhale, lift the arms overhead. So take your time. Lengthen the spine first. Draw the belly in. Maybe gaze up to the fingers if your neck allows. Otherwise, look at me forward. And then exhale, we twist to the left. Feel the twist here into the upper back, into the shoulder. Belly engaged. Keep your sit bone onto the ground. And then exhale back to the center. So we're really detoxing the body here and especially targeting the belly fat. Inhale, lift the arms up. Exhale, twist. And then slowly come back to the center and release. So technically, you should be starting from the right, because if you start from the right with the peristaltis movement, okay, which is a muscular movement, you actually kind of detoxing here all the colon area, so from the right side, lifting up to the center of your core and then dropping down where you release all the toxins out from the descendant colon side. Okay, the last one, come on to hands and knees. So the next one and the last one is a leg exercise, but it's also targeting the belly fat. So come on to hands and knees with the wrist bones parallel to the knees, okay? Remember to keep a nice and long spine. Always looking forward as you breathe in. If your knees are a bit sensitive, you can place a blanket underneath your left knee. We're gonna start with the right. So as you breathe in, press the palms down to the ground. Really spread the fingers. Spread the index and the thumb. Squeeze the elbows in and then lift the right leg back. So you're gonna feel already the belly is definitely active. And then gently, so bend the right knee and we're gonna make those little pulses here. One, belly engaged. Two, you can flex the foot if you want. Three, four. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And release, we do the other side. Lift the left leg up, bend the left knee, and here we go, 10 times. 1, keep here the hands pressing down and then elongate the arms, okay? Never overlocking the elbows, but keep a nice engagement. Lift the spine forward. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And release gently to the ground. And come back to seated position. Okay, so of course, if you are doing that once a while, this is really unlikely that you will get some results. But if you do that every day, I can guarantee you that you will see a big difference. A diet is necessary to come with this kind of exercise. If you want to check my previous video about the breakfast, what I eat for breakfast, that will really help you. If you have any more questions, please don't forget, you can drop me a comment below this video, hit the like button and share with friends and family. I hope it helps. If you have any other queries or any requests, please also drop me a comment below this video. I will be very happy to make a video for you. This video was for Sutish, my friend Sutish, if you watch me, okay? Let me know how you're getting on. And then, listen to your guts, okay? They will tell you what to do anyway. And I'll see you next time. Namaste.